So, hi, internet. My name is Aidda, and I'm doing this video because I know that you're looking at this whole screen about all the entries for the Win Potatoes contest, and you're going like, "Oh my God, there are so many," and you have to click on every single one of them. Why can't someone just do a commentary on all of the videos and watch them for you? Yay! So that's what I did. This is the first video. This is the Win Potatoes video, and these are the rewards. So let's start with how a contest actually should be. It shouldn't be just whoever gets the most views. While that is a good consideration, if Angry Joe made a video, he would automatically win. So that doesn't seem fair. So I was talking with my husband. Husband, say hello.
Hello, Internet.
And we were talking about why can't there be categories like they have for movies, like Best Animated Film? That would bring us to the Fate's Razor video. I have the sound turned off, as you can tell, but this would get my award for Best Animated Video. It's funny. I don't think you've seen this, have you, husband? He's shaking. He's looking at me like, no, he hasn't. If you haven't seen this, if you're not one of those 6,000 people who have seen this, you should watch this. It's very funny. He actually, I think it took him like 6 months to do. I'm gonna click on here. And yeah, so he has a behind the scenes. Yeah, see, 10 months ago was his teaser trailer for this Fate's Razor, and basically it does the whole current story of all the bandits. He has every single race. He has the Char. He has the Asuran.
Char has a very good voice actor.
Actually, I think they're all very well voice acted.
Yeah, but the Char has that engineer voice.
Okay.
Because all Chars are engineer.
So it's 6 minutes. 6 minutes and 44 seconds long. Go watch it. We're gonna put the descriptions into the all the links into the descriptions. So that's Fate's Razor. So then this one is gonna be how Guild Wars 2 stands as of 2017. This is more of a. It's not an animated. It's more of like why you should play, and the reason that I'm picking him is. One, because it is so well edited. Not only is it funny, it shows hots. It shows the game. It talks about what he likes. But yeah, it's really well edited. I'm gonna speed this up. That's the other tip. If you don't have time, yeah, he shows the fractals, he shows the dancing. If I watched this video, I would play Guild Wars 2. But I'm biased. I already play Guild Wars 2. So then there's this one. So I watched this in its entirety. When it started, I actually like watched it. You know, there's some videos that you can just like have on the background. This you would watch. Not only do they talk about the difference between like why is it that the Alolans don't freak out about Sylvaren? They've only been around for like 25 years. Supposedly no Alolans have seen a Sylvari character. Why is there no dialogue about it? But also they talk about all the animated. And do you know who they remind me of? The Powerpuff Girls. Green, blue, and red. It is so funny. I'm nicknaming them the Powerpuff Girls. I'm sorry. But that's literally, like, if you like them, yeah. They don't have a lot of views. It's kind of long, but it's definitely worth watching. They talk about their different experiences with the mount, you know, how one of them doesn't like it, how one of them loves it, you know. They talk about the lore. They talk about what's been going on with the game. They, you know, are trying to get into trouble by, like, finding out where they can take their mounts in through windows. And they show off the demo. So, for me, this category would be, like, a first impressions. So, let's turn that off. This is... Okay, so just like the titles, I actually really like it when they have good titles. It's definitely a plus. So this is geared toward new players. And basically, right here, I have it actually queued up. Character creation. You have 5 races, unique classes, decent role playing. The only thing... So this category would make like a good best tips for new players. I know a lot of new players always complain about, like, if I do search for top tips, I get something like super old. And while old stuff is very, it's still almost all still relevant. If you were a new player, would you watch something that's old or would you want to watch something that's new? Yeah, and so this is definitely something that is unique. He does other gaming videos, so I am kind of worried that he just did, like, one Guild Wars video, and I actually wrote that in there because it was, like, his only Guild Wars video. So I'm calling you out now. Okay, see, a month. So I'm just scared. I don't want the winner... or even second place, or even 25th place, to be like, I did one video, and that was it.
He's got Skyrim. He has Minecraft.
Oh, he has Minecraft. I know. Well, those are even 2 years old.
But it's the Sky Farm and the Blood Altar. It's Minecraft.
It's Minecraft. Okay. So, same lines. This is for new players. Now, so there were a lot of ones that were, like, geared for new players. But the reason I actually fell in love with this one. Let me find it. He talks about every single race, like, in detail. Like, the lore behind it, why it's fun. He even talks about the human meta. And basically, it's really funny how he talks about how the Char and the Inchurin can both have, like, female clothes or male clothes. It is a very good guide. He talks about the mastery. He talks about creation. He talks about how the background choices affect your quest lines. And he's actually made a lot of other videos for Guild Wars. And... in terms of which one he put up is not his best. I actually watched, you know, like this one, and I think some of them are funnier. Like, this one is definitely, like, the start of, and I'm really glad that he's, like, done one, like, almost every single day. Like, you can see he's done one, like, every single day. And he also did Minecraft.
Yay.
Yeah. So, and he's funny. So, shout out to... I'm not going to be able to say anybody's name. I'm just not going to do it. Okay.
Yuri.
Okay. So, this... Okay. I'm giving props to him. Not only does he have subtitles, which some people desperately need. He doesn't. I can actually understand what. I definitely can understand him. But some people, I just can't. So, he actually went out of his way to show he's working on the subtitles. He's keeping us updated. I love that. I love that he does subtitles because, you know, sometimes you just want to, like, you know what's going to happen before he says it. But this guy put together the icons. Have you even seen the icons of your character?
Well, as a char, we play the only character that matters.
Char is a race.
No, char is a class known as engineers because of the Black Citadel.
Okay.
And the only reason that chars exist is because of their engineering powers.
What do you think about like the char are specifically for engineers?
Fidget spinner.
For the homeless business, that's what fidget spinners.
Oh, God.
Isn't that what Guild Wars is for?
Fidget spinners.
Okay. But he does a very good job of explaining each class. I don't know. I think it takes like 2 to 3 minutes for each one. I think it's very well done. I think it's one of the best general overviews of each profession. But yeah, like, shout out. He should get like a gold star for doing the subtitles. Shout out for doing, like, this is one of the one times in a YouTube video where I've actually seen the character
artwork.
Yeah. Okay. So this guy. Now, I'm picking him because there are a lot of videos that just, you know, put on a camera and were like, this is my experience. But he did his story of Guild Wars is very much like the casual player. And I know not all casuals watch YouTube. I definitely think they should. I definitely think we need more casual gamers who are YouTubers. You know, the people who don't have legendaries. Because it seems like every single time I see a YouTuber, they have a legendary.
Well, they might have a MasterCard.
No, I think most YouTubers have actually, like, earned their legendaries. But it's like, you're walking around, and even now, with, you know, there's thousands of people on, legendaries are still so rare, but, like, every single YouTuber has a legendary. So he's just describing how he plays, and, like, how he's casual, and that you want to have a game where you go over a place and it's still breathtaking. And I absolutely love the message. So I'm putting him in that whole, like, commentary, how to play, you know, cause we don't have enough people. And he goes into, like, showing, the game. He actually does, like, a whole thing about each quest, each little area. And, I mean, it's just breathtaking just to hear his commentary about what he sees and how he plays. So, I'm doing the shout-out to Chilled Stock. Butchering people's names all over the internet. Okay, so this title is not what it seems. So, it's 4 minutes and 10 seconds. And this is the comedic. This is how newbies are an endangered species. So it's documentary, and it starts off like a documentary, but it's literally little newbie doesn't know how to play, and you see how a new player dies and dies and dies. And it's so funny. And if you haven't seen this, you definitely need to, because...
So it's a cycle of life.
It's a cycle of life. And he even has... Let me find it. Okay.
The Elton John soundtrack.
Yes. Ha! Okay. So, he talks about how there are... I'm giving the mic over to my husband because I'm laughing so much.
Newbie Black Market?
How they kill newbies. and how you can determine if you're going to survive or not.
That's a big sword.
Mm-hmm. So it's the little newbie
like video. It's very funny. And he did almost all of it himself. So, you know, I really hope that he continues. I subbed to him because I definitely want to see more of the little newbie.
Hey, he
you
didn't
know.
Say any newbies were harmed in this film.
You need to add that, dude. No newbies are harmed in this film. See, we're gonna help you guys. We're gonna help all the entries. So this new category is satire. 7,000, you know, I don't know. This is like maybe, because like the top views are all already at like 75,000. So you take this, this is probably like the fifth or the fourth. You know, there's a big gap between who the high people are. But I mean, this is kind of funny. It's short. We can watch almost the whole thing. So you guys don't have to watch it. There, you watched it.
Not the face.
So I really don't know what to make of this. It's a meme, so it's definitely in the satire category. And basically, he's doing this whole, like, he takes the snippet of what the designer has said and has looped it. So the video has nothing to do with the audio because it's a meme. You know, if you just had the visual, it would be good. I don't know. Do you actually like satire videos?
Shiny.
Do you like satire
videos? Yeah, they're all right.
Mm-hmm.
I think all the shiny. Just $79.99.
So if you haven't watched this, you know, he's definitely really good. I actually hope that he chooses another video because he actually has a really good video. The Wrath of the Shiver Peaks. And if you're a WoW player, so I'll just let my WoW player up. This is bad. We'll edit that out. This is my husband who played WoW. You'll recognize said movements.
Looks like Wrath of the Lich King.
There you go. That's it. Yeah. And we were talking about how, you know, Guild Wars doesn't have a whole lot of like video editing, but this is all in game. And this should be his entry. I really hope that he chooses this.
Yay.
So, go check his out. You know, his old one. His the one that he actually put in. Yeah, so he does a lot of jokey stuff. And he's consistent. So that's decent. Okay, so... see, we're out of satire. So, best cinema. So... I have a bias toward like cinema movies or videos along with like music ones. So this just does a good job of showing the game, like from one part to the other. This is by Guide Hand of Light, Glide. And you know, it's pretty well edited. What did I actually write here? So, yeah, he has no voice, which is fine, you know, for cinema, you don't really need to have a voice, but, I'm definitely, like, I'm, like, number 21, and it is so well, you know, there's, like, over 20 different people have done, like, a cinema, look how great the game is, but his shots are really dynamic. They're very, like, action. He does, you know, world versus world, player versus player. He did some world bosses. It's very well. So, this one is, I don't know. I don't know if this is second. I think this is probably second. Because he even describes how he did, like, map completion. And he took, like, really iconic views of the game. I did like 5 seconds or 6 seconds of each of them, but you can see his character, and I definitely like that art style. I like that whole like vlog-ish, like you can kind of see like the camera behind him. I know my husband doesn't like yeah, but I mean it's decent, it's short, you know, show some love. Show some love to the cinema. Okay. So this one is an honorable mention for the cinema. filter. I'm giving him a gold star for filter. What do you think?
He's used a filter. You don't notice?
No, I don't.
Okay.
Am I supposed to see something?
You're supposed to see something. It's like one of those like Instagram, like you can use filters.
Oh, the color.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I really like this one. I don't think it's the best, but I definitely think it's an honorable mention for the cinema because he puts together like cut scenes and then also game stuff and, like I said, filter. He's very good at filter. So keep up the good work. Yeah. Okay. So this one, so why you should play Guild Wars 2. And see, who do I have this as? So this is the best non-voiced, and you can't hear it because I have it unmuted, but it's rock music. It's really good rock music. And he puts all of his stuff in here, and it's definitely very funny. Which rock music he chooses. So you actually have to go listen to it to experience the rock music. And, you know, I definitely love it when people add, like, their own music ideas. And, you know, he does a good job about putting, like, words in different places so that you're not just, like, reading a scrolling thing. It's, like, you know, it goes on the top and then goes at the middle and then goes on the bottom. And he picks really good places to choose. You know, the lighthouse from LA is always a good place to show off. I don't know about his fashion choices. I guess you can see him. He's the shiny. Okay. So, this is 5 Reasons to Play Guild Wars 2. So, this is a normal category. And he talks about his 5 things. The game is free. You know, content is on schedule. That Guild Wars 2 is very accepting of new players and newbie characters and vet players. And the expansion's coming out. So the reason I'm choosing him, he doesn't have a lot of views. You know, he does a very good editing idea. So I think this is more of like the infomercial because it's so short. You know, infomercials are somewhat short. You know, if you don't have a lot of time.
And he used text to speech.
He what?
He used text to speech.
He does.
Because his mic doesn't work.
Yeah, that's true.
Which is weird.
Okay. So this is. When I saw this, I went, oh my god, I have to make a new category. I didn't even, like, this would not be, like, in the movies, but for awards. But this is a guild. This is a, I love my guild, and that's why I play Guild Wars 2. And it is so funny. And maybe it's just because I like Corgan, but they're, like, they're doing the race. And I mean, I want to be part of this guild. I want to be in this guild because it looks so fun, you know. It's really good. And I absolutely, I'm a sucker for anything about, you know, guilds and, you know, people interacting with each other. So it definitely shows off that, like, how people can have fun. Okay. So that's a new category. Okay, so now we're going to get into the role players. And yes, I have a special area for them. So this story has been done before. I know you haven't watched a ton. It's the story of Marjorie getting into, like, that information about joining the story and investigating the kid who died, and, you know, she's a necromancer, so she gets to talk to them. her take on it is so good. I mean, you get the text, you hear her voice. She's almost as good as a regular voice actor, but she also gets someone else to play the guy. And it sounds like he's very monotone, like you want from an evil character. I can't do monotone. I'm not. So the reason I love this so much is I went and I was like, I want more. And she has more. She has. I'm surprised I've never seen her. I'm surprised that, like, you know, as a role player that I am, that I've never seen anything from her. So, yeah, I absolutely love it. She does a really good job at showing it off. So shout out to, and I love Marjorie. I love the Marjorie story. You know, she does this whole, like, short shots. Because, you know, there are some people who, like, you know, can just do a podcast and, like, their video has nothing to do with what they say. So I love it when that video actually goes.
Yeah, that sounds like a bag of potatoes.
Okay, so here's my other role player. You know, I absolutely love him. He's the tail from the pale tree. He's the Savarin thing. And he does a really good job at, like, explaining the Savarin. He uses a lot of cutscenes. And what I really like about it is it's his own script. It literally is his own script. And I really hope that, like, he finds his voice. Like, I really hope that he continues writing. I really hope that he, you know, does more. I want to hear more about his little Savarin going to the... Okay, so now we get to the music. Corvus, you can't talk about Guild Wars 2 music without Corvus. You know, he's on Guild Gab. Shout out to Guild Gab. Shout out to Corvus. This music is so good. And it's really funny. Like, if you're on Twitch and you put on, like, any of Corvus's music for, like, song requests, almost all of the Twitch streamers know the songs. Like, that is how well known Corvus's songs are. Like, even if you do it for, like, Mighty Teapot New, Inks New, Peachy New, like, all the songs. Like, he is the king of music for Guild Wars 2. Like, inspired music. So then, I was going through the entries, and I was like, I love this guy. I love this remix. I love how he puts a little, I don't know, what is that bar called? I thought that was a really good touch. You know, he puts a bunch of, like, cinematics, so you're not just seeing, like, one thing. It's actually kind of like action. Yeah, so, you know, I went through and I was like, okay, let's see what else you've done, Mr. Toasty. And I was like, I wonder if toast is supposed to be for your breakfast and you're supposed to listen to it in the morning. But yeah, he has, like, so many other songs.
He should make toast.
But he has a lot of other songs. They're all very well done. You know, I definitely like the Equalizer. Then we get to the full album. And this is so unique. Like, I don't know if this is, should be first, because it's a whole album. And, like, you know, it's 34 minutes. And he does each profession. And each of a profession has its own. I love the engineer. I'm biased. I love the metal that it has. So you have to click on it to hear the music. So that's what we're hoping for. You know, he's definitely out of the three, I think it's only like three people have done like music. Like, those are the top three. And they are so well done. Okay. So this is my how to do Photoshop for Guild Wars 2. And it was actually really surprising because, like, when the Wooden Potatoes contest started, a lot of, like, Guild Wars 2, the official channel, actually has, like, a Saturday how to do art in Photoshop or Adobe, or I don't know what program this is. I'm not a photo person. But his video is so pretty. And it's, you know, I kind of wish that, like, people who know how to do good pictures and people who know how to do good music would, like, collab. I know. I'm wishful thinking.
Yeah, they did. They made a game.
They made a game. But I definitely like it. And it's the only one of its kind to do, like, a photo. So I made its own category. So far it's winning. Okay. So, next category. Get someone new to play Guild Wars 2. This is a whole reason to have the contest. To get someone who's either from another MMO or just your husband, like I did. I cheated. So this is an old WoW player. And she... It's so funny. Like, it's a minute long. And it is so funny. And, of course, she made a char, which is perfect. And, you know... People love it, and it's been out. It's not even, like, it's September 2nd, and today is, like, September 10th, and it's, like, she does so well. Like, it's, like, a thank you and tribute category. And she actually, I think she's recorded her entire level 80 experience. So, you know, she definitely should get, you know, one of the top spots for the Win Potatoes contest. So this is, this one should get a gold star. You know, awesome kitty. He got his mom to play Guild Wars 2 and recorded the experience. And I feel kind of bad because not only did she go from, like, not knowing how to use the keys, like, to go forward or not, but her son made her do player versus player and then world versus world in, like, a 2-hour period. And it's really funny. Like, she is, like, I think, like, 62 years old. So she gets an award for, like, the oldest person on camera. Maybe. But it's literally, like,
have your mom play. So does your mom play video games?
My mom doesn't play, but it's the idea that anyone of any age can play Guild Wars 2, and that is phenomenal for getting people to play, to come to it.
I wish my mom played, you know. It's definitely a very sweet thing, you know, if you definitely like the whole, like, have your girlfriend play, you know, having your mom play is, like, really sweet.
Yes, we need more videos like that.
We do. We need more videos of Awesome Kitty.
Because her name is Awesome Kitty, and I'm going to check to see if he has any more, because no. So, definitely need to make more of Mom playing Guild Wars, you know. So, this is Heidi's thank you, thanks to Guild Wars 2. And this is more of a, you know, thank you. You know, it's not really a, you know, helpful, it's just showing how great the game is. You know, he talks about world versus world. He does his own little audio. It's kind of like, it's sweet, you know. And he does really good editing. You see, you know, gets a little shirt on the guild table. You know, it's very well edited. And it's a, you know, just thank you. So I made my own little category of all the thank yous. And this is the winner so far. So, yeah. Then there's Guild Wars 2 is Beautiful. And this is more of the whole, like, this is my gaming experience. I went from a gamer to a role player to an MMO to how Guild Wars 2 has captured everything. It does, like, everything right. And he showcases, like, each different thing. So, if you're going to watch a video and you like that whole thank you Guild Wars vibe, you know, the I'm a role player, I'm a gamer, this is my journey. You know, because That's really what it's about. It's about how you connect with games.
And how they impact you. I mean, this is a really interesting video because it has a very strong narrative on how it impacts his life and his experience from the eyes of playing as a character. And it really brings in something that Guild Wars has that some other games might not have.
Definitely.
And I'm a sucker for anyone who pours themselves out on YouTube, because I know it's rough. So this is a funny kind of take of how they waited in Heart of Thorns. And basically it's how they did the same guild mission over and over and over again. And it's funny, you know. It's definitely funny. She made it in 2015. It's still relevant. You know. It's definitely still relevant. See, there's only one answer. And it's to cry. I do. I don't know if I want to refund for HOTS. I'm almost there. You know, being stuck at HOTS for this long. I'm definitely ready for the expansion. Same with this person. I'm definitely ready for the expansion. I'm definitely glad that we're not waiting like we did for HOTS. You know, it was like 6 weeks and boom, we get it. So this is definitely, you know, going down the memory lane. So.
I know you haven't seen this. This is the version of game theory for Guild Wars 2.
It's like cooking.
No, there's actually a cooking channel. I don't think he submitted. Oh. But it's literally game theory.
Cool. Math. My head hurts.
Your head. You're good with math. You're the one who does all like the stats and stuff.
So it's actually really funny. I think his very first one. So he's talking about how tall the volcano is. Because, you know, in-game characters have human rights too. And he's talking with his character. He's narrating, he's the player, his character is a separate person. And characters have rights.
Well, at least he plays it as Sharon. They are pretty smart.
They are very smart. Sharon's are very smart. So, if you haven't checked this out, if you like game theory, you know, I definitely should, like, I want to send this to, like, MatPat and be like, dude, put this on as like, one of those side stories, like, Goomba. So, I definitely love him. You know, I'm subscribed. I'm his second subscriber. But, yeah, it's really funny. So, if you haven't seen that, okay, ew. It's short. It's funny.
It has 3 easy payments of $19.99.
So it's the infomercial. When I saw this, I said, oh my god, we have to make another category. It's the infomercial. It's like what TV has, you know, late at night. You might even get like your extra con bath towel with it.
You might get 4,000 gems for $79.99 too.
That's true, yeah.
But it's 50 seconds. You know, he definitely needs more love. Hey, so one of the last ones we're going to talk about is the video that has the name quotes from Sigh. And this is a like guild love letter. And I think it was really sweet, you know, when I... Oh, it's doing the sound. Let me turn off the sound. And the cat doesn't like me. Yeah, my cat's in here, so I'm re-recording this. I'm a noob when it comes to editing. But when I listened to this video, it was really cool, and it's basically, I think it's like how most of us feel about our guild. It's like the place that we belong, and he gets like these quotes from guild mates, and it's really sweet. So I want to kind of end on this one, because it's one of my favorite videos, and... You know, I definitely I definitely think it deserves more than 421 views. So, you know, if you're looking for a guild, you should join Sai. You know, it's definitely really sweet. So, thanks. Okay. So, I did this one already. Okay. So, this is the International. I think this is Polish. You know, the whole area is, you know, the whole world needs to be represented. This is the only international entry I have seen. Now, I haven't seen all the videos. I have not seen everything. So what I did was, because I'm lazy, just like every good casual gamer is very lazy, I made a playlist. I made a playlist of every single entry that has been in the Wooden Potatoes video, because I don't have to click on all those again. I never want to have to click on them. I just want to be able to pick it out and be like, I want to watch this girl. Like, I've had it on, like, auto, and, like, every single time I see something, I'm like, oh, that sounds cool. So this is, I'm putting this up in my video. This is the ultimate playlist. This is 136 videos, and I will go through every single one and watch it now. So I'm definitely putting all of that in there. I haven't seen everything. You know that I've seen you if I've commented, or if I've, you know, I'm not going to comment on, like, the really big ones.
That's a lot of
potatoes. And I'm going to go back to what I like to do and play the game. I'll see you out there. Aidda out.